we'll just dive into it, I think.
I've heard about Azure Static Web Apps since it came out several months ago. So I figured, why don't I take the Gatsby app for stream overlays and try to get that on an Azure Static Web App. So that's what we're going to do, which I think is going to be fun. I've done a little bit of it. I haven't done everything that we're going to try to accomplish today. So there will be a learning experience there. Expectations for me is that I can easily create an app inside of Azure. That thing will connect to a GitHub repository. Anytime I push to that GitHub repository, it will do a build and it will be up and running. And that's basically what I expect. Let's run a Gatsby develop inside of this thing. So the goal of this thing, let me change the order of this. There's my bot, by the way. So I have in Figma, these are not finalized, but I think I've shown. I'm going through some design updates. Something like this will be my new stream overlays. So I haven't actually incorporated that fully into Gatsby because I'm waiting on final design stuff. But the stream overlays are a Gatsby app that is right here. I could say like coming soon or starting soon or something, I think. Yeah, there we go. So it'll add that text. This will actually let me cycle through different pages with my left and right arrows. So you can see me doing that. And there's some things to figure out with this. But that's basically what we have that I want to get hosted that will use serverless functions. So we'll try to get that up and running too. So let's go into Azure. Inside of Azure, I'm logged in now. I am clicking on a static web app, create a new one, as you would probably expect. And then name for our static app. So this will be JQQ stream overlays. And if I remember correctly, this should be completely unique. So here's the thing that I think a lot of us probably expect. You sign with GitHub, you connect to a GitHub repository, and that's how this thing is going to get deployed. Sweet. So we've got basic settings for like the resource group, the name of the static app. And now we want to actually connect it to a repo. So we can choose from a organization. If you have multiple, you can then choose the repository, and I'm going to choose the JQQ streams, and the branch is a master branch. Let's review and create this. So we should have it connected to the right repository. This is going to ask where is the app location and the API location. So we will move some serverless functions into the API part here. So let's go ahead and do a create. And one of the things that they do here is, well, at one point it asked me for what type of app it was. Says it is complete. Let's go to the resource. Let's go and see this thing. The web app is live and waiting for your content. So even though this is connected to the GitHub repository, the code isn't actually deployed yet. What it does is it runs this GitHub action to do a build. The way that it works is if I stop my local copy and I do a git pull on master, notice right now there is no GitHub folder or .github folder. If I do a git pull, now there's a .github folder inside of workflows. There's Azure Static Web Apps. So if I look inside of my build, there's actually an error. And the reason is cannot use the window inside of the server build. So you can only use that on the front end in the hydration. So you need to do, I think we can solve this by just surrounding this little bit with that. So inside of my navigation, I'm looking at the window to grab the URL. And then based on my key down events, I will be able to change pages. So that's why it's like a debugging thing. I think what I'll do is I'll say that the current route is this. And then we can say, so if there is a window, then we can update current route to be this thing. So we can call this a let, then current route will be updated if the type of window is not undefined, meaning window is there, meaning we're running in the browser. If this is still running, our localhost 8000, I just want to see that it's running. Left and right can switch pages, so that stuff is good, which means it hopefully will work on the server now. Conditionally looking at window object if in the browser. I guess we could also do a Gatsby build locally to make sure that that is going to work. Let's try that first. So we're getting another error in here inside of, where is that? Inside of this one, URL search params. We will start off with let text equals just nothing. Let's move this thing up here and then let's update text accordingly. Let's do GST, get add, checking for window before using document. If we look inside of Azure, let's go to the root of the repository, then actions is where I wanted to get to. And now it's doing this new build. This also is looking for in here an API directory. We don't have that, so we're going to get to that. Right now, my serverless functions are configured for Netlify. Pretty cool that we can kind of move from platform to platform and not have a lot of changes in our code. There'll be a little bit of configuration stuff, but that's kind of it, I think. And I'm wondering, there may still be one thing we're missing. Oh, it worked. What? Hey, look. That's great. And if I left and right, now I can switch. So this thing is fully deployed. So that thing is hosted up there on Azure. That's cool. Now, the thing that you'll notice, and this is where the serverless function comes in, it is looking for James Q Quick, and it should show this other name. It's a 404 when it makes a request to the get stream function. So that's where our serverless functions are going to come in. So we'll need to take a look at tweaking the serverless functions that we have to fit what Azure expects. Let's go to JavaScript, and we want an HTTP trigger. That is the name. And this is what I'm looking for, is just this file. Let's move this inside of API. So we're going to test this out here. Maybe something like this. Hey, so there is our HTTP trigger. Permissions denied up here. Okay, not exactly sure why that is. One of the things we can do is we can give this a test. So let's rename this. Test endpoint. If we deploy it, I would like to be able to see it, to be able to hit that endpoint directly. Let's go ahead and publish this thing out. Go to our terminal. Let's add all of this stuff. Added first pass at a test API. This thing looks like it completed this job. So I did a build. So it shows me that that thing got picked up, which is great. Azure has now picked up, just from us having that file there, it has picked up this endpoint, this file as an endpoint, which means, and hopefully this will work, is we can go to /API/test endpoint. Hopefully this will just return to us a little bit of JSON. Sweet. So that worked, which is pretty dope. The only difference in what we already had and the endpoint that they just created for us is a little bit of syntax. So I think what we can do, I'm going to leave these files and now change what they export. So get stream, we will kind of copy this code. Just to start, let's paste this in down here. Looks like we can just do the context.res. So we don't need the status code. We can do the context.res equals, it's going to be this object. And one of the things I like is that you don't have to stringify your objects. I don't need this log. We can do context.res equals, and then do a status of 500. So it goes out of API into source and then utils Airtable. So that should work the exact same, hopefully. Go into update stream. This takes a little bit more logic. So let's paste in this example here so we can have it ready. And this one, we're wanting to do a little bit of check. So we'll grab the ID, the title, the guest handle, the paste correctly. So we've got our new definition. It takes in context and rec. And what we need to check, we don't need to do the JSON parse again. So that is actually nice. And then we'll look at the rec body. Context.res equals. And then this is status, like that. So now let's grab this part. All right. And let's remove this part. Context.res equals. And this is status.res is status 500. Let's get into here, do a status. We want to updated the two serverless functions for Azure functions. Do moved serverless functions into the right place. All right, let's push that up. It'll run a build and we'll see if that works. So it said the API was found. So, and it did that before, which is good. Looks like it finished finished upload. Polling on deployment. Let's go over to Azure again. Let's do a refresh on here. And do we see those come through? Yes. Thank you. Cool. This is an async function, which means I can do await. It returned back a status of, maybe we can do this. We can return back a body and return the error in here. Update stream index, same thing. So down here, body is error. And then let's go into Airtable. Airtable does the configuration. It gets the stream table. So let's do added error to body. It will make the request to get stream. Since I didn't return anything, I think it won't actually show me. Let's try this out again, just to be sure. So what I did is I ran F5, which should, in theory, start up my serverless functions and do a debug of them. So let's do an npm install here of Airtable and .env. Let's check the git ignore to make sure this is ignoring node modules anywhere. Yeah, so I think we're good there. Added package JSON in API folder. Let's give that a shot. Looks like it completed this job. Hopefully, if we try now to do, looks like we got the same thing. So not sure why that's happening. We might have to revisit this in the future to figure out. I imagine it's some sort of small configuration thing. We did end up adding the package JSON in here for those two packages. And I think those are the only packages that are referenced. Something we're missing in there. We'll need to figure this out. But this has been cool. Everything seems to just work the way I expected with static web apps, connecting it to a repository, getting it deployed. Kind of cool that it goes goes into the actions, the GitHub actions for doing those deployments, and it does that configuration for you. Looked into getting the serverless function running, and there's some sort of configuration or something that we're missing, so I can get that figured out. Once we have that, then that function will be deployed right where we expect it to be and be able to be used inside of this application. But anyway, that was a fun experiment, getting to check out Azure Static Web Apps. It was cool. Thank you for everybody for hanging out. Appreciate it. I had fun, and I'll catch you later.